Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario World. This one, I didn't even hit that. I guess I'll hit it the next time. But the purpose here is, oh la la, time crunch, we gotta do a speed run. You wanna know why? Because it's Chocolate Island 2, and this one has the most bullshit secret exit you could ever deal with. I guess I'll explain it on my way through time crunching my ass through this fucking level. It tells you that the amount of coins and time remaining in your level determines which exit you get. I think I may have gotten... Yeah, I think this is the secret exit one. So, let me just check, because I'm not sure. Oh, crap. Your bombardment of baseballs shall not last forever. Die. Yep, it is. So, what you need to do is you need to complete that first area and that second area I think it's 200 seconds, to be honest. The coins might change the amount of time, but I think regardless of the amount of coins you have, I think it's you just have to have 200 seconds left on your clock by the time you finish that area. That's what I've always thought it was. I could be wrong, but I've always completed it in that amount of time and just rushed through it, and I always get it, so... Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Oh no! No! Give me the feather! Anyways, this is the chocolate secret. Again, it's like this game almost, like, alludes to the last level, or the last world, because, like, this is the second time we've entered Bowser's world and not actually done anything in it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's kind of cool at the same time. Okay, this is... I always jump over that because I always... Whenever I did it normally, I would always miss it. But... Anyways. Yeah, I think it's kind of cool because it's almost like they're, like, alluding to the last level in this, or not, I don't know why I keep on saying the last level, but the last world, you know, but I definitely think that it's cool, even though Bowser's world is not really my favorite one, but it's definitely interesting, And I'm really not going to say what the name of it is yet. I don't know. I'm trying to keep this, like, I'm not trying to spoil shit. Like, I know probably 100% that probably everyone who's watching this has already seen this entire, or has played this entire game. But I'm just making it under the assumption that, well, people may not know everything. And I know it's Mario. You really can't spoil a freaking, like, timeline in Mario. We're gonna go back. That pipe just leads to the World 6 Castle. It's a shortcut. I would show you, but I detached the L and R buttons from the mapping because I was having a lot of problems with it. If you remember, in, two episodes ago, I was. Wow. No! What a bunch of bullshit! I hate these things. I mean it. They are the devil. And they fucking suck so much. Okay. Now we just gotta waste time before we go into this next pipe, because we don't want to have to get stuck with the secret exit again. Oh! Bam! Suck on it. That is magical, what I did there. And I lost it. Okay. We're just gonna waste a little bit of time. We're gonna wait till it hits about, once it goes below 200. So, if you guys don't mind, I think I'll just use the fast forward button for this. There we go. I don't really consider it cheating. I just consider it, a time saver for the videos. I really don't think most people are gonna crucify me for using something like a fast forward button just to waste time. I'm not even doing it to make, like, the level change. Well, I am, but at the same time, who the hell wants to really watch me just, like, have Just, like, sit there waiting for the time to burn. So this is the normal exit. Like I said, it says coins in time, but I never really knew what it meant by coins. I've never really had it change based off of the amount of coins I had. Yeah, I don't really get it much, but... Okay, Chocolate Island 3. This one's real fun. I'll get the normal exit first, rather than the secret exit, just to show you, because this is really, really funny. You'll get a hoot out of the normal exit if you've never seen this, because this normal exit is really fucking funny what happens with it. So, let's just see it. As you can see, there's a bunch of blue Koopas, which can possibly make this level a blowover level. Like, seriously, if you have a Yoshi, it can make this level really fucking easy. But I don't, so I'm not gonna be able to just, like, blow right past it. And then, you know what they do? They add in fuzzies. Fuzzies. Our favorite fucking friends are fuzzies. Not really. But, I always like fuzzies because they always look like they're tripping on fucking, like, crack. Like, look at their eyes. They seriously look like they're in a drug-induced state with, like, I don't know what the fuck they were thinking when they made these, but seriously, they look like they're like, man, these colors, they're so outrageous. Okay, as you can see, the normal exit is up here, yet the signs keep on pointing this way. Are they pointing to the exit or are they pointing past the goal? Well, that's for your own interpretation, but... we'll just get the normal exit, which is right here. Just watch. This is honestly one of the funniest, like, things they've ever done to screw with gamers who just went with their gut. Just watch. Assholes. Assholes. My god, assholes everywhere. They did that to us. Yep. What an asshole. Whoever thought that was... like, I think it's funny, but I think it's also kind of like... I and the reason why I'm kind of sore about this is because when I was little, I'm definitely not old enough to be old enough to have owned a Super Nintendo, but if anyone... who was probably my age when you owned a Game Boy Advance, you may have remembered, they made Game Boy Advance. Don't die on me! Oh. I was scared. I was scared. Oh, holy lord. Well, now I can't float everywhere, which makes me sad. Actually, I need a fucking feather, and if I don't, I can't do this level. That's saddening. Let's see. Yep, there's a block. I was gonna be fucked if I couldn't get a feather, because I was gonna, like, wait a second. Because you actually need a feather or a Yoshi to get this. So, no. Wow, really? See, I don't know if that's gonna work. Is this gonna work? Yes, there we go. I was afraid they put it at the same level as that one was at. So, there you go. This is the secret exit. You have to just fly past that normal exit, and you get taken to here. I'm probably gonna stop getting goal tape, because I think it's kind of stupid how much I've gotten. Like, I have 58 lives. Look at this. I have 61 lives now. Yeah, we're gonna stop hitting gold tapes, because I really don't need it anymore. But that opens up to the actual, you know, Chocolate Fortress, which allows us to progress onward, which is nice. It's kind of fucking annoying when they do shit like that. But it's kind of funny at the same time when you're like, you know, like, LOLs, they literally tried to fuck us over with this. Oh shit. They have the little, like, Bowser fire generator on. See, I thought, when I saw this, I was like, wait, are we gonna fight Bowser? Because, you know, they always did that in the original ones. The little fire thingies. No. Okay. For this level, that was stupid. I thought I could fit there, but I couldn't. Oh, bam. I'm flirting with disaster over here. But, yeah, this is a fairly simple fortress. If you have all the Switch Palaces, it makes it extremely fucking easy, because they reward the people who have the Switches. Like, and you'll see this real quick, like that you have to do, but this one you don't have to worry about, and this one you don't have to worry about. So, otherwise, you gotta deal with that. Now, some people would argue, the game's not as fun when they do shit like that with the Switches, you know. I don't really think so. I think, you know what? Let's have the world end over here. Yep. Yay! I'm not even standing on the wheel. I'm standing on the floor. I'm being such a rebel. Not really, but I felt like doing that. Okay, Chocolate Island. Probably gonna do longer videos. Probably around like 17 minutes. I know I'm probably around 10 or 11 minutes right now. Oh shit. Okay, I'm good. I don't know. There's no secret exit for the rest of this world. No secret exits. They kind of get them out early, and they make them a pain in your ass early. And then they kind of get out from being a pain. And the rest of Chocolate Island is kind of just dicking around. Like, I'll be honest. Like, this shit, they get really fucking generous. Like, Chocolate Island 4 and Chocolate Island 5, I never really remember much of it because they're really not levels as much as it feels like they're just bonus stages, to be honest. Like, look at this. You have that, coins, that, this, this. Takes you to a bonus stage. Like, seriously. You're supposed to, like... Which, by the way, those are, like, free coins. People don't always really realize that. And then, like... You just kind of float down. You know. And that. So, like... There's really not much. Like, this is... This really isn't, like, as much of a level as it is. It's really just a bonus stage. And, like, none of this is really that challenging either. Those are coins. I'm going to trust I'm not going to fall into chocolate death. I don't know if their idea of hard is just putting these mole things here. And that's the end of the level. Like I said, and you'll see Chocolate Island 5. You will literally want to say, these people are just... fucking giving out free shit for no reason. Like, it makes the game almost not even, like, fun, because like, the last half of Chocolate Island 5 is actually levels, and I understand, like, oh, well, they're making it a little bit more challenging because, you gotta unleash spinies, but at the same time, it's really not like that whatsoever. Like, here. It's honestly, it's outrageous. Like, they give you a free mushroom if you didn't have them. They give you that if you don't have that. Like, another free mushroom. Like I said, it's just outrageous. There was really no reason for the amount of free shit they just give you. And, like, if you wanted to, you could get 1-ups from getting a star over there. Like, it doesn't really make any sense. Oh, well, actually... Okay, that's actually close, because if I was to fuck that up, I actually would have died. And this just takes you to the bonus game, which I suck ass at. Oh, look at that, I got a 1-up, though. Oh, I got another 1-up. So, as you can see, the amount of lives I've been getting is outrageous. So, and for this area, I think I will prefer to have a cape. Because we're dealing with the pipes that extend in these things. And I think they eventually, yep, they get around to putting Chucky. But once they put the Chuckies, it's really not tough at this point. Because it's the end of the level. So, The moral of the story is here, once you beat the Chocolate Fortress, you get two, like, blow-over levels that aren't even hard at all. And then we move on to Wendy's Castle, which has a little bit of challenge. It's definitely a breath of fucking fresh air from the last one that... Holy shit! You... I don't... You're not even supposed to be able to pick this up. And I managed to pick it up. How does that... I don't even know. I think I glitched through the wall or something. Well, that's interesting. But as you can see, this is not a blow-over level, as we have the spiky penises from hell that try to destroy us. Oh, here's something I should point out. Never, ever... I died. Never, ever, ever spin jump on two spin jumpable items at the same time. For example, if those two grinders, those two saws, are overlapping at the same time and you spin jump on them, you will die. Or you won't die, but you'll take a hit. So just be careful with that. I don't know why that is, but it is true. So, that's why I was kind of freaking the fuck out, because I knew if I spin jumped on it, it would pretty much kill me. So, the best way really to avoid these is really to just normal jump, because you get more lift on a normal jump, and you can't land on them, whether you wanted to or not. Shit. But, she's definitely very, very grinder happy, which really isn't fun, because they suck ass. Oh shit. Now, these are the, like... These are the super sex thrust penises, and they will destroy you. So I suggest not touching them. Don't think we have to really deal with them much. Oh, this was a bad idea. I'm glad I got out of dodge there. She also likes to deal with layer 2 a lot. If you don't know what the fuck layer 2 is, that's definitely more of a hacking term. It's whenever the solid objects move, but it's not very commonly used, really. It's a fucking pain in the ass. This part, really, once you hit this area of the level, it's not too bad. And we will see that Wendy is just a repeat of Lemmy. Oh no, I want my life, because... Shit. Oh, this isn't gonna end well. I'm so bad at these. No! I hate Wendy's level. Oh, damn it. Really? You can hear the sound of sex thrust penises over there. And here, we just gotta go through the same level. Bear with me. I usually cheat the fuck out of this boss. And I have to do it legitimately, so... This will be fun. This will be super fucking fun. I hate this one. It's those damn fireballs. Like, seriously. The game is so much easier without them. And that just makes them so much fucking harder. It's outrageous. Fuck. But, we're pretty much... pretty much done with, like, luckily this area doesn't really take much time to do, so, we're back into it, let's not die this time. Okay, hit, there we go, one hit down. I don't care, get the hit, and get out of there. I can afford, there we go, yes, I don't care if I'm small again. I won! Sweet victory! Just happy. Thank you. Time for another Morgan Freeman voice. Wendy O. Koopa in Castle Number 6 has sung her last song. Mario must meet the challenge that is now before him. There is a sunken ship that appears to be a gateway to the Valley of Bowser. Okay, oh, well. Well, I'm an idiot. I just activated the caps lock. You know what? Let's do this. This might be an extra long video, but I don't care. This is worth it. If I can do this without dying, it'll definitely be worth it. That's right, you can't go over there. I was waiting for them to fire. Oh no! Oh no! No, I need it. Okay. Here, let's try to do this quickly. Even though there really is no quick fucking way to do this level. The Sunken Ghost Ship. Yep. I am definitely not a fan of this level. I've never really found it fun. Because this is where they make this shit appear. And let's see if I don't completely die. Because it always fucks up. And it will, a lot of times, actually just spawn booze, like, right on top of you. But whenever they disappear, the best strategy is just to stay still. And your chances of it doing that are very little. I don't know. They don't spawn in when you have to deal with, and I think they only spawn for that area of the level, so just realize that. In case you don't know about Mario swimming, if you're a swimming noob, if you just press B, normally with Super Nintendo, you do a normal swim up. If you press down and press B, you swim down, like, what do I want to say? Oh shit. I've never liked this part of the level. Because it's like danger. I always just hug the wall because I'm always scared. I'm scared to jump down here. Oh no! Oh no! Please don't. Oh no! Are you kidding me? What? We'll do Sunken Ghost Ship part take two in the next video. See you guys later. Until then, bye.